North Platte Valley is one of the richest agricultural regions in the world. From sugar beets to dry beans and beef, the bounty produced by area farmers and ranchers creates thousands of jobs. The valley would be a far different place were it not for an event that happened more than a century ago. Hundreds of miles from where you're standing, the building of the Pathfinder Dam. In the 1880s, a few hardy frontier farmers were scratching out a living along the North Platte River near Gearing and Minotaur. They became the region's first irrigators, digging small ditches to bring water to riverside fields. In 1902, President Theodore Roosevelt championed legislation that created the agency known today as the Bureau of Reclamation. Its mission was to build irrigation projects that would provide reliable water supplies throughout the arid West to encourage settlement and agricultural development. Within a few months of the agency's establishment, surveys were underway to find a suitable location for a dam on the North Platte. Several sites on tributary streams were rejected in favor of the site in Big Canyon, below the confluence of the Sweetwater and the Platte. Pathfinder Dam, which bears the nickname of explorer John Fremont, is a triumph of design and engineering. It uses a cyclopean masonry construction technique. Massive blocks of cut stone are fitted closely together with mortar joints. Pathfinder was one of the first of the gravity arch dams designed for the West's high, narrow canyons. A gravity arch dam transfers the load of the water stored upstream to the downstream canyon walls. Cheeseman Dam in Colorado and Theodore Roosevelt Dam in Arizona were among the first dams designed this way. Pathfinder Dam was one of the largest dams in the world at the time that it was built. World-famous Hoover Dam was the largest gravity arch dam on the planet when it was completed in 1935, eclipsing size records set by Pathfinder and others several decades previously. Getting materials to the job site in 1905, which was not accessible by road, rail, or boat, was an enormous, expensive challenge. Tons of freight needed to be hauled 45 miles through rugged, high desert terrain by horse-drawn wagon. A bag of concrete that cost $3 at the depot in Casper cost more than twice that much by the time it got to the site. The shortest trip made between Casper and Pathfinder was 3 days. The longest took more than 2 months. Many of the workers from Cheeseman Dam, including a contingent of Italian stonemasons, headed north from Denver to work on Pathfinder. Construction of the dam's foundation didn't begin until November 1905. But by then, the contractors had built a bunkhouse, mess hall, offices, root cellars, and latrines. When foundation work began in early winter, ice and snow complicated everything. Crews occasionally had to chip through several feet of ice by hand before digging down to bedrock. After nearly 1 year, the first stone was laid in August 1906. Despite the remoteness of the site, its machinery was state-of-the-art. It included 10 derricks with 60-foot booms, 2 cableways, and a concrete batch plant. Finding and keeping qualified labor was a persistent problem. Laborers earned 35 cents an hour, about $10 an hour in today's dollars. But more laborers quit than stuck it out. They were unable to handle the hard, dangerous work. Extreme weather, loneliness, and rough living conditions. Fuel was also an ongoing challenge. Oil and gas were too expensive to ship to the site, so a logging camp was built in the Pedro Mountains about 10 miles distant, and a crew worked there for 2 years to cut the cordwood that fueled steam-powered machinery. The dam was completed in 1909, and the reservoir began filling. Heavy runoff that spring led to rumors of an imminent dam failure. Nothing happened except a little unwarranted worry among Casper residents. More than a century of service has validated the exceptional design, construction, and engineering that Pathfinder Dam represents. It was placed on the National Register of Historic Places in 1971. The reservoir behind Pathfinder Dam holds more than 1 million acre-feet of water, enough to flood all of Scott's Bluff County to a depth of more than 2 feet. Getting that water to the farmers who needed it was the next challenge after the dam's gates closed. Between 1905 and 1924, more than 2,000 miles of canals, laterals, and drains were built across Wyoming and Nebraska. The regional economy boomed when the water arrived. Scott's Bluff County became one of the fastest growing counties in the nation as immigrants arrived to work in the fields and factories where sugar beets were grown and processed. But success was far from universal. In fact, more small farmers failed than prospered. Those who succeeded were farmers with experience in irrigating crops. The North Platte Project is a huge, complex system that stretches for hundreds of miles from Pathfinder Dam on the west to Bridgeport on the east, providing irrigation water to nearly 400,000 acres of cropland. Its main features include Pathfinder Dam and Reservoir, a diversion dam, several storage reservoirs, 3 regulating reservoirs, more than 1,600 miles of canals and laterals, 352 miles of drains, and a multitude of small control structures. In 1909, a diversion dam system was built in Whalen, Wyoming, to direct some of the North Platte's flow into the interstate and Fort Laramie canals. These canals follow the contours above the valley floor. In Nebraska, the interstate canal is directed into Lake Alice and Lake Minotaur, which act as irrigation reservoirs. The North Platte Project delivers electricity as well as water. Some power plants, like the one at Lingle, Wyoming, were decommissioned in the 1950s. Guernsey Dam and Power Plant were completed in 1927. Guernsey Reservoir stores about 70,000 acre-feet of water, and the power plant generates enough electricity for about 1,300 households. During the Great Depression of the 1930s, crews from the Civilian Conservation Corps built recreational improvements at the lakes. The boys of the CCC also built control structures, lined canals, and planted thousands of trees. Additional benefits of this complex water management system include recreational opportunities and improved habitat for many wildlife species. So while you're in the Panhandle region, think about these things that happened more than a century ago, hundreds of miles upriver. Whether you're putting sugar in your coffee, going boating, enjoying a good steak, or just turning on the lights, it all started at the dam called Pathfinder.